In this life, there are many things that go together. There's salt and pepper, there is love and marriage, there's my favorite, Lucy and Ricky. But today, it's all about fish and grits. My favorite. It's had a chance to grow with me through my childhood, and I can't wait to show you how I do it. My super spiced catfish starts with tender sweet baby catfish that get a spicy coating of my own blend of herbs and spices. I dredge it good and deep fry it until it's golden brown. It sits on top of my cheesy garlic polenta that's finished with heavy cream, a little butter, and Parmesan cheese for a velvety smooth finish. Add on my wilted firecracker spinach and tie this meal together with my Chardonnay cream sauce, and you've got a meal that's perfect for any occasion. It's satisfying, it's hearty, and it's just good food. So let's get started. All right, first things first is we got this catfish. Now, this to me is just simply amazing. I've grown up eating catfish sort of my whole life. My grandmother used to make catfish. It's kind of the thing that we had, and this is amazing. So normally what you see is you'll see, you know, catfish steaks, the nice big meaty steaks, but you know, we're gonna go for something a little bit different here. So I'm gonna actually use the baby catfish. I love it because it's sweet. It's milder, you know, and we're gonna be a little elegant. All right, we're getting some water started for our polenta. Now, I love fish and grits, and so polenta sort of is right up my alley. I'm using chicken bouillon because I like the way it sort of helps fortify the chicken flavor. And I also like it because it adds sodium as well. And sodium is salt, you know, salt is flavor, and it's gonna be really good to sort of balance out our fish, all right? So I put about 2 cups of water, so I'm doing probably about 3/4 of a teaspoon for sort of each cup of water that I have in there. I'm just gonna give it a stir and let it come to a boil, you know? And what we're gonna have is sort of instant chicken stock. Now, trust me, you can do this method or you can go ahead and use chicken stock in the box or the can. It's completely up to you. Doesn't really matter. Getting some oil hot for our fish. Let me show you what we got. We got this amazing catfish here. This baby catfish is nice and it's gonna be real sweet for you. We're gonna give it a sort of a season with some salt, all right? And now I'm gonna grab some pepper. And I got a couple more spices that I gotta add to it because it is my super spiced catfish that I love. And let me tell you, boy, do I love, love, love catfish. We used to have it pretty much every week growing up. It's a staple in my household. My grandmother used to make catfish all the time and it was some good eating, all right? Outside, crispy and crunchy. The inside flesh, nice and juicy and sweet. So this is gonna be great, all right? So, got a lot of stuff going on here, but again, it's called my super spicy catfish, all right? So we already got our salt in. I'm gonna give it some fresh cracked pepper. I'm gonna give it a little bit of granulated onion, right? Some onion powder, it's gonna be good. I like the way onion powder adds a little bit of a, you know, sort of a zip, a little tang, if you will. That's good, right? Here is some garlic powder, all right? A little bit of chili powder as well, that's gonna be great. Some herbs, all right? Now, I'm gonna use some dried herbs. I always keep these on hand. I have the big, you know, the big jumbo containers because I like them and I use them a lot. This is not the place to use fresh herbs only because what's gonna happen is that the herbs are gonna actually burn off and that is not what we want at all right? So, oregano, super spicy. So I've got some super spicy stuff, crushed red pepper, and then obviously a little bit of some dried basil, all right? This is great. Now I'm gonna show you what we do to make this stick a little bit, all right? A little bit of water. That is the key, not a lot, a little bit. And we're gonna get in here and get all of this good flavor sort of mixed all throughout. And this is gonna be absolutely amazing, all right, for our fish. All right, so let me get my hands a wash and I'm gonna show you how we're gonna coat. I'm gonna show you how we do it. I'm gonna grab some cornstarch and some cornmeal, all right? Because sort of cornmeal is kind of how we did it growing up. So, you know, every time I do it, it sort of reminds me of being back at my grandmother's house and having her fry catfish, which by the way, she cooked very, very often, all right? So I'm gonna throw in some cornstarch as well as my cornmeal. Now I will tell you this, you sort of never really see me frying without cornstarch. Cornstarch adds a nice crunch. It really makes things just sort of nice for you when you fry it up. The air pockets and the air bubbles are really good. So I'm gonna just throw in equal parts, right? No science here. Equal parts of cornstarch and equal parts of our cornmeal. Clean hands, and I'm gonna get in here and get everything coated and dredged really nicely for us, right? And that looks really good to me. So the longer this sits, the better the coating has a chance to really adhere and stick. And everything's gonna be on your fish when you fry it up and, you know, not in the oil. And that's exactly what we're going for. So this is good. I'm gonna leave it here. I'm gonna get my hands another wash and check me out. Look at this, all right? So we've got this water and our sort of bouillon, our instant chicken stock, and that's gonna be great. Meanwhile, let me get an onion and some garlic chopped up because we're gonna do some spinach and we're gonna do this sort of amazing Chardonnay cream sauce that sort of ties the whole thing together. So I'm gonna go ahead and chop up, let's say, about half an onion. I'm gonna use some for our sauce and the rest for our spinach, but I gotta tell you, this is gonna be great. It's just sort of taking, you know, what we used to eat back in the day, sort of what we grew up on, and elevating it a little bit. You know, we're giving it sort of growing up, if you will. All right, so I'm gonna get some onions going, all right, and some garlic. And I'm gonna tell you, I'm also gonna love making this Chardonnay cream sauce. It's gonna go right over top of everything we do. It's gonna sort of tie the whole thing together. It is going to be fantastic, you know? So you can do the same sort of cooking application we're gonna do, and when we plate it up, with anything. It can be done with fish, it can be done with chicken, but let me tell you, you gotta get into some catfish. It's gonna be great, all right? I'll tell you this too. I remember I actually, I'm in Chicago now. I used to live in New York, well, New Jersey, the New Jersey area. And you know what I couldn't find? I couldn't find catfish, right? So I was forced to sort of try all these other fish that are out there, some bluefish and some haddock. And you know, they're good, but let me tell you, I gotta tell you, there's nothing like catfish for me. Catfish just sort of screams Southern, you know what I mean? It screams home. This is gonna be great, all right? So look at me, a little onion dice for us and some garlic. And that's the basis of a great sauce, all right? And if your sauce does not begin with onion and garlic, hey, I don't know, all right? I don't know. Look at that, all right? And our onions. All right, and that is doing great things right here. That goes to our side. And I'm gonna get our polenta started. Now, let me tell you, if you have never had polenta, you're doing yourself a disservice. You must try this. If you like grits, great, right? Polenta puts you in the mind of that. And then the way we're gonna season it up, I mean, what's not to love, right? It's the same sort of cooking method as, you know, as grits. We're gonna add our polenta, and it's already boiling, so we're gonna go ahead and reduce our heat because we want this to really be sort of a low and slow, sort of creamy, velvety thing happening, and I'm gonna help it out. I've got some surefire methods, sort of an insurance policy, if you will, that's gonna make it nice for us, right? So in the end, we're gonna add in some butter, we're gonna add in some cheese, a little bit of heavy cream, and that's just really gonna make this taste sort of amazing, all right? So if you can imagine where we're headed, we are heading to a fun time. So at this point, our fish should be ready to go. Surefire way. Now back in the day, grandma used to take a little bit of the flour or the cornmeal coating and put it on, and look at that. As soon as it starts to sort of bubble up, we're all good. But you can also take the end of a wooden spoon, drop it in. If the wooden spoon bubbles like that, we are all ready to go, all right? Make sure our oil is nice for us. Look at this. Our baby catfish are gonna go in, all right? So I'm gonna get our baby catfish to frying. I'm going to continue to stir our polenta. And listen, when we come back, it's more fish and grits. Don't go anywhere, all right? Hey guys, glad you guys are back with me. Just making more of my easy fish and grits. Oh yeah, look at that boy. Look at that catfish. Now, this is baby catfish, my super spiced baby catfish that's gonna be absolutely fantastic. This has tons of herbs, tons of spices. It has some garlic and some onion, a little bit of salt, some pepper, a little bit of spicy stuff going on. All right, check me out. While you guys are gone, I just went ahead and sauteed up some onion and garlic, real simple, onion, garlic, a little olive oil, salt and pepper. Gonna go ahead and deglaze a little bit of white wine. This is for our Chardonnay cream sauce, maybe a little bit more. All right, and what's the use of having white wine there without having a little for me, you know what I mean? So, pour myself that, and this is gonna be a fantastic meal, all right? Check me out. In the back here, I've got our polenta. Remember our polenta? that we did with our sort of chicken stock in a flash, you know what I'm saying? That's great. Our polenta has been cooking very low, very slow, and it's just about ready for what we're gonna add to it next, all right? To finish up this meal, let's switch this out. And we're gonna grab that pan. We're gonna do our firecracker spinach, all right? Which is gonna be really simple. Now, I love this sort of play on spinach. It's gotta be a little spicy. We're gonna put a little acid with some lemon juice, a little lemon zest. It's gonna be absolutely fantastic, all right? So, right when this reduces down, I'm gonna go ahead and hit it with some heavy cream. We're gonna taste it to see if we have to add any more salt and pepper, and we're all good. In the meantime, though, it's time to get our polenta cracking, baby. All right, so I'm gonna add in half a stick of butter to that, all right? I'm gonna also add in some heavy cream, okay? That's what's gonna make it nice and velvety and smooth, and that's gonna be great, boy. All right, and listen, if you're adding in cream, you're adding in butter, you might as well add in its close relative cheese, right? So I've got some really nice Asiago cheese here. I'm just gonna grate this in. I've already been using it, as you can see, right? So I'm gonna grate some of that in. This is gonna be great. This is gonna give us a little bit more salt content, and it's gonna add a really nice nutty flavor, nutty texture. And while I'm grating this, I am standing over this Chardonnay that is reducing, and I gotta tell you, boy, this smells good. I just love when food just smells good. Can't even talk, got my mouth full, right? So cheese goes in, look at this. Give this a stir. Make sure everything is really well incorporated. And that is a hot spoon. So I'm going to grab a towel so I don't burn myself anymore. I'm gonna turn our cream down, our cream sauce, or the base of it down a little bit, all right? And I am multitasking because not only am I polentaing, not only have I fried fish, which smells great, reminds me of my grandmother's house growing up. Oh, look at that. Look at that. That is going to be some good eating right there. But I've also got some olive oil getting nice and warm for us. That's going to be good. I'm going to taste that in a second. Olive oil getting nice and warm for us, because what I'm going to do is I'm going to throw in some onion and garlic that we sauteed. This is going to be for our firecracker spinach, all right? So onion and garlic go in, and going to get a whole lot of spinach down, which you know, of course, is going to wilt down to almost nothing. You hear that? That's part of our firecracker that I want to hear, all right? Give it a toss with some salt. I've got to add in some pepper. We need pepper, all right? So this is gonna go in, and that's gonna be great, just like that. All right, I'm going to use the juice of a lemon, but if I'm using juice, might as well use the zest, right? So I'm gonna go ahead and zest in. Look at that, oh yeah, that's gonna be great. And as soon as you do this, like the essential oils, you sort of already smell them, because you know we are in flavor town, baby, all right? So that's gonna go in. Let me go ahead and cut it open. All right, and I'm just gonna go ahead and pop that juice in. Look at that, okay? Yeah. All right, and it would be firecracker without some fire. So a little bit of red pepper flake go in. Oh yeah, okay? So we're talking about a good time. I wanna get some tongs to just stir. Oh yeah, see that? And just that quick, we're done. Now tell me, how easy was that, all right? I'm gonna give our heat a little zhuzh here. All right, I'm gonna get in a little cream, Chardonnay cream sauce. Chardonnay's done its part, all right? The cream is gonna do its. All right, I wanna get this sort of incorporated and blow this up. Meanwhile, I'm gonna get some parsley chopped. Now listen. I know I said in the beginning that this meal reminds me of my childhood. And in my childhood, my mother and grandmother, they were not reducing Chardonnay, they were not chopping parsley. So, you know, this has had a chance to sort of grow up, all right? So this is a really good meal that I used to have all the time. We had fish and grits all the time growing up, but I said to myself, what could I do to sort of elevate the flavors, you know what I mean? And I think my firecracker spinach, I think that using the baby catfish, which is a little sweeter to me, and go ahead and making our firecracker spinach in this cream sauce does just that. Well, look at that. That's gonna reduce. Now, I don't know where you get your cream from, where I get my cream from. It doesn't come seasoned, so a little bit of salt makes everybody happy. I want to stir and taste this, okay? Oh yeah, babe, look at that. Okay, now just imagine polenta, right? Back in my day we had, it was grits we used, right? But this is polenta, it's a sort of an Italian grit, an Italian corn grit with the cheese, the chicken stock. I mean, it's gonna be loaded with flavor, all right? And I get to do the honors. Look at that, look how velvety smooth that is, right? And it's only because we cooked it low and slow. Remember, don't rush this. This is a labor of love, right? A constant stir. Let's go for a taste. Oh yeah, it's where it's at, all right? Look at our sauce. I wanna give our sauce a taste. Oh yeah, that is delicious. Look at that, all right? And you just wanna let it reduce down and get nice and thick so you can taste the cream and taste the Chardonnay. Give that a taste, see where we are. Oh yeah, oh yeah. This is it, all right? So let me tell you something. It's time to plate up now, all right? So let me show you how we do this without making a mess of everything in the kitchen. Show you how we do this, okay? I'm gonna go ahead and kill the heat on everything. And I'm gonna grab some of our polenta, right? Look at that. This nice polenta, velvety smooth, right on the bottom. Oh yeah, look at that. All right, I'm gonna grab our tongs, a little bit of our spinach that I can't wait to taste. It's gonna be fantastic, right? And this was easy. I mean, easy spinach. It started with just a very simple saute of onions and garlic, a little bit of olive oil, salt and pepper. And then we added in the lemon juice and we added in the lemon zest, all right? Look at this, our catfish, all right? I fried up two big juicy ones. And these are super crispy because you know why? We used not only cornmeal, but then we also went ahead and we used the corn starch as well to sort of fortify, give us an insurance policy, all right? And then let's get some of this sauce. Oh yeah, just spoon right on top. Now my grandmother is no longer with us. She passed back in 1999, but let me tell you, I know she is smiling down on me saying, boy, you have done me proud with this sort of a meal here. All right, look at that. This is going to be fantastic. All right, I'm gonna give it a little bit of that for some parsley, and let's give this a taste, and let's see what we're working with, all right? Check this out, let me see. All right, and I'm trying to get a full bite, so I'm gonna get a little bit of the fish, the crispy fish with the sauce, some spinach. Rich and creamy from the polenta, the bite from our firecracker spinach. And it's great because there's lemon in the spinach, so it really helps offset the savory of the fish. This is great. A little bit of white wine. Mmm. This is fish and grits. Listen, two things you should know. Food is my life, and life is my food. For recipes, videos, and so much more, go to my website. It's www.everydaycooking.com. Until next time, I'll see you right here. This is Everyday Cooking.